In the last 7 to 8 years, I began to develop a different comic voice and a different perspective. Comedy, stand-up comedy is a low art. It's a vulgar art. It's an art of the people. It's not
funny. But it's an art.
But it is an art. It has to do with interpreting the world as you see it and then writing something and then delivering it verbally. And I found a very liberating position for myself as an artist. And that was, I sort of gave up on the human race, and gave up on the American dream and culture and nation, and decided that I didn't care about the outcome. And that gave me a lot of freedom from a kind of distant platform to be sort of amused, to watch the whole thing with a combination of wonder and pity, and try to put that into words.
Not caring about the outcome, what do you mean by that?
Not having an emotional stake in whether this experiment with human beings works. I really don't care. I love people as I meet them one by one. People are just wonderful as individuals. You see the whole universe in their eyes if you look carefully. But as soon as they begin to group, as soon as they begin to clock, when there are 5, 10, or even groups as small as 2, they begin to change. They sacrifice the beauty of the individual for the sake of the group. I decided it was all under the control of groups now, whether it's business, religion, political people, or what, and I would distance myself from wishing for a good outcome. Let it do what it's going to do, and I'll enjoy it as an entertainment.
And I'll reflect on what it is on its own.
And I'll enjoy it for the entertainment. There's a little bit of a sick part in this, too. I root for the big comet. I root for the big asteroid to come and make things right.